Hey friends, it's Deanna here, and today we're working on the kids cuddle up top and leg warmers pattern, which I am super excited about. I love leg warmers and I love the look of this top, which is kind of blouse and a little bit poofy, and it's just super, super cute. And the leg warmers, I mean, who doesn't love leg warmers? Very, very cute. So I'm excited. I'll be making this one for my little niece, and yeah. But before I get started, let me remind you of our Fun Fan giveaway, a $50 Ellie and Maggie certificate. Ooh, ooh. And all you have to do is subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. So go ahead and subscribe right now if you haven't. And then comment below, and that will enter you for our giveaway. $50 Ellie and Maggie certificate. You know how many patterns you can buy with $50? Quite a few, because you know Ellie and Mac has great, great prices. So go ahead and do that, and then we're gonna draw winners. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get started. Like I said, I'm making the kids cuddle up, and I already cut out my pattern, cut out my pieces, and I'm ready to get started. First thing we're gonna do is, this is my pocket. We're gonna grab our pocket binding, and we're gonna grab it, we're gonna fold it wrong sides together, and we're gonna give it a little steam. Always make sure that your iron is set to the correct heat and you don't end up burning your clothing. I've done that before. Not the best thing. And then we're gonna fold that in half and go to the front, and where the fold is, and that's gonna be our half. So we're just finding the half, and I cut a little tiny notch. It's just a little tiny piece, but if you don't wanna do that, you can just mark it however you would like to mark it. Pin, clip, however you do it. I got my pocket. This is my side of my pocket. So you can see the shape of it. These are the sides, the pocket sides. I'm gonna go right here, and I'm gonna meet up the two raw edges and find that middle piece of that as well. I am using this is a sweater knit that has great stretch. You know, you never know what you're gonna get with a sweater knit. That's why I love, this I got from August Fabrics. Olga's Closet. Olga's Closet is what it's called. And she does a lot of lives where she shows what the fabric it's like. I know people ask me all the time what the differences are between the fabrics, how much stretch. You really need to read the information below the fabric that you're getting, especially when it says something like sweater knit, because there are so many different kinds of sweater knit. This is a sweater knit, and it's got like really, really good stretch. It's a brushed sweater knit. And then I've got, for my leg warmers, I'm using this sweater knit, and it actually looks more like, it's got the loops, so it kind of looks like a French terry, but it literally has like a very little amount of stretch, which will be fine for my leggings because I'm making them for a little baby, and she has tiny legs, so they're just kind of squished up. But for my leggings, for the cuffs, I am using this one with a lot of stretch because obviously the other one didn't have much stretch, so I want something that has stretch around. If your child is a little bit bigger, you wanna make sure that it has good stretch so that their legs are not gonna be like souped up tight in there, you know? So you just wanna make sure with that. But yes, this one has great stretch. So it is kind of hard sometimes to tell what kind of stretch a fabric has. It comes with time. If you have any fabric questions, just comment below and I will try to help you as much as you can. We do have those videos with the different fabrics that Sonia did a little while back. You can go back and check them all out and see. She has great information about different fabrics. And then we do have a thread on our Facebook page. If you want to go check it out, if you have questions about fabrics, you can post them there and we'll get back to you and try to help you with that. But, yeah, this is a very good, got very good stretch. It's a sweater knit, so it's a little bit thicker, but it's really, really soft and cuddly for the cuddle up, you know? Anyway, but like double brush poly, cotton lycra, any of those, French terry with good stretch would work. All kinds of sweater knit, or like I said, you have to know, and then you can use like rayon spandex, but that will be really, really thin, so you want to make sure that Depends on what you want to do, what the look you want to go for. I would tend to go more towards the sweater knit because it's more cuddly than the rayon spandex, which is thinner. And I mean, it's just the look you're going for. It's up to you. All right. So anyway, now where we mark that half and where we mark that half on our pocket, we're going to meet those two together, right sides together. And we're gonna meet the raw edge. So the raw edge at the top and the folded edge is at the bottom. And then we're gonna kind of pull and stretch a little bit to each corner. And stretch a little bit to each corner. I know I talked a lot about fabric, but I know that it's, you all wanna hear the information on the fabric. I just wanna be thorough. I just want you to know what I'm using. But there it is flushed. And I'm gonna go ahead and sew that right there. Now I'm using my serger, and actually I got a new serger. Someone was so great to me and gifted me this serger. Thank you very much. You know who you are. And it was a big blessing to me. So I'm using a new serger. My other serger was about to die. And this one's not as loud as my old serger. So I'm sewing that on. And if you are using a sewing machine, I would recommend that you grab your fabric, maybe a piece of scrap fabric, and you try different stretch stitches on your sewing machine and see which one works best for the fabric that you're using. Lightning bolt, just a regular stretch stitch, whatever it is that you're trying to do, zigzag. You want to make sure that it's something that will let you have some stretch. So I always kind of check. And so now that I've sewn, I'm going to go back and steam that down. And then you can top stitch if you want to. You can go back and top stitch that, turn it around and top stitch that pocket around. I will not be top stitching today. I like the look of it just being smooth, so that's why I'm not top stitching. With some stuff I do top stitch, but sometimes I don't. This one is my Autumn Spice and it's not top stitched. But sometimes if I'm doing like a grungy look, like a darker and kind of different vibe, I will top stitch. So it's up to you. I'm gonna grab the front piece. Okay, now, the difference between the front and the back, that way you don't get confused when we're gonna do the front first, because that's where we're gonna attach our pocket, it's that the front you did, it's more of a straight at the bottom. It kind of goes up a little bit, but it's more straight. The bottom you will have, let me show you. The back goes kind of rounded down. See how it's longer? You cut it longer, so you want to make sure that you have the one that's up higher. Okay, that's the front. So you, because you, when you cut the pattern, you cut one with the straighter line and one of the curved line. The back is a curved line, so you want to make sure you grab the right one. This is the front. I'm gonna fold it right sides together to find that top middle piece, the where the half is. And the top is the rounded up, see that? And then the bottom kind of goes up and down, kind of straight. So you want to make sure that you're doing it on the right place. If you can't remember, grab your pattern piece and place it on top, and that will help you. I do that all the time because I just want to make sure that I do it right. I'm going to find the middle piece on my pocket as well. So I'm folding it in half, my pocket, and I'm going to the front and finding that middle piece right there. Okay, so now where I found the middle piece of my pocket, I'm gonna put the middle piece of my, of my bodice right here at the top, and I'm gonna pin the two sides too. And then we're gonna pin right here on the sides to flush with the bodice, the pocket with the bodice. Choop choop. And then we're going to baste them on. Now, basting is just doing a long stitch over. Sorry, my bracelets are all cut up and it's annoying me. Okay, it's a long stitch, the longest stitch on your sewing machine that you can kind of keeps it together so that you don't have to worry about it coming apart. And it's something that you will pull off. You'll pull it off once you sew it on. I mean, once you assemble the pattern together. So it's not something that's gonna stay there forever. I have pink thread on my Michelle machine right now because I made
What did I make that I used pink thread with? What did I make? I can't remember. Something I used pink thread for. And still there, but it doesn't matter because it's just a basting stitch, something that's gonna come off later. I'm just gonna pull it off whenever I sew this bodice front and back together. Okay, and then the last side. And I'll show you what I mean by that. See, it's just a long straight stitch that I'll just pull off whenever. But see, there's no pins and it's still staying on. That's what you want to do. You want to make sure that it helps you stay on. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to do, and I'm going to do it with a basting stitch as well. I already have that middle piece right here, but I'm going to grab my front bodice. Now, there's the back and the front, and the front bodice is the lower neckline option. And it's already folded in half, so I'm going to find the center, bottom center. And I just make a little clipping, because that's what I like to do. And find that, see that right there? That's the middle. Well, what we're going to do is we're going to gather this skirt to fit, the bottom to fit the top. But we're not gonna gather all of it. We're only gonna gather this piece right here. So we're gonna gather this as much as it needs to be gathered to fit the bodice. Does that make sense? We're gonna gather just the pocket area, not the other pieces. This is gonna straight the other ends of the pocket. Just the top of the pocket is what's gonna get gathered. So how I'm gonna do that is I am going to do on top of this basting stitch, not on top, but alongside of it, I'm gonna do another basting stitch. If you wanted to use this basting stitch, you can. All you have to do is pull at the basting stitch and it will help you gather it, really. Honestly, you can kill two birds with one stone. I don't know why I was gonna go make another gathering stitch. Like really, I don't need to. And I am all for cutting corners when you can. Not always, some things you have to do. But see, now it is gathered the width of our top bodice. You see that? The same width. This right here is gathered. You can tell, and it's so cute. See how it's gathered? Oh, this is gonna be so cute. I want it for me. Okay, so now I'm gonna tell you this. We're gonna do this exact same step to the back bodice. So I'm gonna move this away so I can show you how you're gonna do it to the back bodice, and then I'm gonna go ahead and do it. But I just wanna show you so you're not like, what did she do? Okay, so as you can tell, this is the higher part going up. So this is gonna be my top. You see what I mean? This is going up. No, I'm lying. Okay, this is when I'm confused, and this is what I told you to do when you're confused. Grab your pattern piece, put it on top. Yeah, I was right the first time. That is my bottom. See how it doesn't fit right? That is what you need to do if you can't remember. All right. Now, you see there is these gathering pieces right here. You can put that on top and you can use that to mark your pattern piece of where they're going to want you to gather. But honestly, I'm going to grab the bodice and show you in a minute. Let me pin this. Okay, that's where they want you to gather on. So I just transferred those marks. I'm gonna grab my bodice. This is my front bodice. This is my back bodice, okay? And I'm gonna mark the middle of it as well because I wanna make sure that I'm finding where the middle is to help me put it right in the middle. And then I'm gonna find the middle of my skirt, my bottom of my top as well. The middle. I wanna find the middle. I want it even. Okay, so now that I've got my middle, but if you open up your bodice, it is basically where I marked is pretty much the ends of the bodice. So, I mean, if you don't want to mark it, you can just gather right here where the ends of the, where it ends, just gather that inside piece. Kind of like over here, we gathered at the inside pocket. Here we're going to gather just that inside piece as well. You see that? So I'm going to put a basting stitch from this pin to the next pin, a basting stitch like I did the pocket over here,
and gather it, the width of this, just gather this right here, just from pin to pin, to make it the width of the back bodice. I hope that makes sense. If it doesn't, please comment below and I'll try to help you out a little bit better. So I'm gonna put this aside because I'm working on this front right here now, and I wanted to show you first how we're gonna do it, since this already has that basting stitch. It's already gathered the width of the bodice, the width of the top of the bodice, okay? Now, for reinforcement, I am not doing it today because I ran out of clear elastic. But for reinforcement, and let's pretend this elastic is actually clear elastic, which is not, it's way bendier. We wanna use clear elastic to reinforce this skirt and the hold. It's good to use it because if it's something heavy at the bottom, if you don't have that reinforcement, it can pull it, drag it down. And that's how that has happened to me before when I'm like, I don't know if it's gonna happen to this because I ran out, so I'm just gonna do it like this. But if you have clear elastic, this is what you're going to do. You're going to grab your clear elastic and you're gonna cut it the width of the skirt, leaving a half an inch side for you to be able to hold on to the clear elastic as you're sewing it on, because sometimes the clear elastic will tend to like want to like come out when you're trying to sew it on. You don't want it to do that. You can go ahead and pin it, but sometimes you don't, obviously you can't sew it with the pin on. So if you have a little bit of extra, you can hold it by that and pull it and kind of help it along. Not pull it, but you know, like help it along. And then we're gonna put it right at the raw edge, right at the edge. And we're gonna grab our bodice and feed it right on top. I'm sorry, I'm lying to you. You want that to be on the inside. You don't want it to be on the outside. So you put it right along the edge. You can put it on the inside. And then if you want to go ahead and baste it on to your top or to your skirt first, so that it's on there, and then sew it together, you can do that. We're gonna find the middle piece and put them right sides together. Okay. And then we're going to keep going all the way the raw edge. Raw edges together, and I'm pinning. And again, like I said, you're gonna do the same step to the back bodice. I'm just showing you in the front bodice, and then I'm gonna go do it and do the back bodice as well. So I just wanna show you. Okay, so once you have that top attached to the skirt, to the bottom, like so, you will have that elastic, clear elastic back here where you can see it. And when you sew that on, you want the pleats to be face up like this so you can see what they're doing, and the clear elastic so you can see that you're sewing it on, okay? Again, I'm not doing the elastic. I don't have any clear elastic. I ran out. I just made a 90s dress from the updated version. And so I used my last little bit on that, but this is what I'm gonna sew. And I'm going to do my back bottom as well. And then we'll come back and we'll move on to our next step. All right. Now we can go ahead and pull that basting stitch off. If it comes out easily, then that's great. If it doesn't, like if you searched on top of it for some reason, you might have to pick it out with your, whatever you call it, seam ripper. Yeah, mine is kind of breaking because I kind of went over it a couple parts with my serger. To avoid that, if you want to, you can go ahead and just sew the basting stitch a little bit lower than the edge, and I didn't do that. Now I'm gonna go back and steam it. Always steam your seams and steam them going the same way. Look at how cute that's turning out. You got the little bit of gathering right here at the waist, which is so cute. I'm still pulling some stuff out. There it is. Okay, now I have my front and my back. I did the same for my back like I showed you. See, it's got a little bit of gathering right there. Now we're gonna put them right sides together, the front and the back. Right sides together. We're gonna meet at the shoulders. shoulders, right sides together, shoulder seams, and then we're going to meet, there's more. This is the one from the back. I haven't pulled it yet. I'll have to go back and pull that later. And then we're gonna meet at the sides. Now remember that your pocket was basted on, but match up those seams of the where the front and the back meet. And then make sure you pocket it's in there when you're gonna sew it on where you basted it on. And then the same for the other side. I like to cut these leftovers off. Okay, and then again, your pocket right there, make sure it's secure. And then we're gonna go ahead and sew those sides together. We're gonna sew those sides together. We're gonna sew our shoulders and our sides. All right, so my sides are sewn together. That's just fuzz. And I was making sure that my pocket was cut and that nothing else but my sides were on there. So my top is basically done. Look how cute this is. I love it. You wanna make sure that you seam those sides down and you can go ahead and remove those basting stitches where the pockets were in. I always wanna make sure that my seams go the same way, all the way up. I don't want half of it going one way, half of it going the other way, because then it will look all wiggly at the seams. Don't like that. Okay, so now here we are. Next step, we're gonna do our sleeves. I'm doing short sleeve, but it's basically the same thing, except for obviously the long sleeve will be longer. Okay, so I'm gonna put my top aside for a little bit. I'm gonna grab my sleeve. So this is my short sleeve, but if it's a long sleeve, it's gonna be a little bit longer. We're gonna grab our sleeve. We're gonna fold it right sides together. I am going to find my top because that will come in handy later when I'm attaching it on. So I'm just finding where that top edge is. And I'm gonna sew that raw edge, the side, okay? This is the top of the sleeve. This is the bottom of my sleeve. This is the side. If it's a long sleeve, you're going straight down the side. I'm not pinning because it's just a small part. It's not very long, so that's why I'm not pinning. But if I was doing a long sleeve, I would probably pin, maybe. So I cannot find my sewing scissors. And then I have some other scissors. And then I've had these sewing scissors are old and I inherited them for a long time ago. And I know I have scissor sharpeners somewhere and I don't know where it is. So they're kind of dull, but they're really, really nice. I just need to make sure that I sharpen them. I don't know why I haven't. Okay, not that you really care about my sewing scissors, but I'll just give you an explanation why I'm going and I'm trying to like sew it off. Okay, so I've got my sleeve. Now, with my long sleeve, it's going to be more needful. Is that a word? You're gonna need to do this more with a long sleeve than you do with a short. But you see how my cuff is gonna end up a lot smaller than my sleeve, you know, because you have to stretch. Well, these sleeves, if you've seen the pattern, it's kind of cute. It has a little bit of a poof effect, just like it does on the shirt. So it's going to be gathered a little bit more than you would on your regular cuff. A regular cuff doesn't give you that like bloused effect. But this one is kind of going to give you that bloused effect. Now, I already did one of my sleeves, as you can see. It kind of has like that bloused-like effect, like bubbled. So that one I just kind of stretched the heck out of. So you can do that. You can just go ahead and work on your band, which we're going to in a minute, and just kind of quarter it and stretch it as you're going. Or you can go ahead and gather, put a gathering stitch on the bottom of your sleeve. Go around and put a gathering stitch like we did on our bodice. Remember that long straight stitch? And then pull the sleeve and gather it at the width of the cuff. So you can kind of make it down. But let me go ahead and work on the cuff first and then I'll tell you, I don't know if you're getting lost, if I'm going ahead of myself, I'm just talking too much. So we're gonna grab our cuff, we're gonna fold it wrong sides together. I wanna give it that crease so I know where I'm folding. Again, make sure that your iron is set on the right setting. Look at that steam. So that you don't burn your fabric. We're gonna put it right sides together. We're gonna sew that short raw edge, and it kind of blends in with my top. Short raw edge. These scissors have such potential, but they just need to be sharpened. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and fold it on that crease that we already made, right sides together. You see that? Our cuff is ready to rock and roll. And we can go ahead and pin that back, that seam together. And we're gonna do the same thing, go out to the front, and that's my quarter, and we'll make a pin right there. If you wanna clip, you can. And then here, if you wanted to just quarter, you can do that. And then just kind of match them up. But like I said, it's a lot smaller. Your cuff is a lot smaller than your top. Especially, I'm making like a really, really tiny size. I'm making the smallest size. So that would be hard. There's like a pin sticking right here in my sewing machine, ready to break it. No, no. All right, so I'm gonna put that basting stitch all the way around. And sometimes if you want an easy method of gathering, I've learned to just kind of grab the thread a little bit as you're doing it, and then it gives it a gathering effect. But I don't want to do that right now because this is such a small sleeve, it keeps trying to come up, and then it's gonna get all cut underneath and it's gonna be a mess. All right, so I got that basting stitch on there all the way around. You can see the pink thread. I'm gonna go ahead and pull it. And like I said, just gather my sleeve, the width of the cuff, which is not a whole lot. Just gathering it a little bit. That, it might be easier to do this than to try to like I did the other one. I just kind of pulled as I'm sewing around, and it's so tiny that I'm like, oh my gosh. Now I'm gonna tie the threads back here at the end. That way the gathering doesn't come undone as I'm sewing it on. And then like it'll be gathered on one spot and then I'm like done sewing it on and I'll have like this huge piece that is not gathered and I'll get mad, I'll throw things, and that will not be good television. My mail lady. It's my mail lady. She is awesome. I love her so much. We're like this. I see her all the time. I shouldn't be saying that. I am obsessed with buying fabric. I'm sorry. Anyway, I'm fitting that cuff into my sleeve. You can do it each other way you want. Each other way. Whichever way you want, you can turn the sleeve inside out and fit the cuff in, or you can just fit it on top. You just have to make sure that the right sides are touching. And where is that middle piece that I clipped? Here it is. You want to match the middle with the middle. That way it's even. Okay. So now it's gathered. We're just going to go ahead and sew it on. Can you see it? It's kind of small, but it's just at the raw edges right here. And we're going to sew that around. Ooh, you all, I'm so excited. Fabric mail is like my favorite mail. And I know I'm getting fabric because I got a notification on my email. So there better be some fabric out there. Oh, okay, so I want to make sure that I'm grabbing it the right way, that the gathers are good, and that, and actually, honestly, I said you could do it whichever way you want, and I did it the other way, but it's easier if you do it the other way where the ruffles are sticking up so you can see your gathers as you're sewing to make sure that they're even and make sure they're not going to look all wobbly. I'm gonna go ahead and sew this together and we'll move on. All right, look at that from underneath and make sure you cut everything. You don't want a piece hanging out that is not in there, and later on you have a hole and you'll be so upset with yourself, so upset. Okay, see my gathering stitch is still in there. I'm gonna turn it right side out. I'm gonna pull that gathering stitch off. Don't need it anymore, it's already sewn on.
Come on. All right, pull it off. Come on. Oh, it's because I had tied it. That's why. Okay, and now we're gonna go ahead and steam. Like I said, I wanna steam that seam down, all going the right way. I want it all going the right way. So now my sleeve is done. You know, the one good thing about doing with pink is that you can really see the thread to pull it off. The one bad thing is that you can really see the thread. So if you don't pull it all off, I'll have little pink threads hanging out. Look at how cute that sleeve is. Tell me it's not adorable. Man, it is. Even if you tell me it's not adorable, I still think it's adorable. So, yeah. All right. Now, we're going to sew our sleeves on. I know on the one I already found the top before I sewed it together, but on this one I didn't, so I'm finding the top where the, oh, I thought I did. I don't see, there it is. Yeah, I did. We're gonna grab our armband. See right here where this is where the sleeve is supposed to be. We're gonna turn our bodice inside out. We're gonna grab our sleeve. We're gonna fit our sleeve into our bodice, and we're gonna match the armpit seam, that seam right here with the other seam. And then that spot that we found right at the tippy top, we're gonna put that right here at the shoulder seam. At the shoulder seam. And then we're going to line up those raw edges. Line them up, pin them up, get them ready, sew up. Okay, that didn't rhyme, that didn't sound right, that was awful. I apologize. I do not have a career in singing. I know this, okay? I've already acknowledged and I already have realized that I don't sing. I have other talents and singing is not one of them. So my raw edges are met together. And now I'm gonna sew around and I'm gonna do this for this one and I'm gonna do the same for the other sleeve. I always like to start at the bottom seam where there's already seams, like at the armpit area. That way I don't have seams everywhere. So we're gonna start right there. I'm gonna go all the way around the whole shabuckle. Don't even know if that's a word. Make sure that your bodice is not trying to come under you and get caught in there when you're sewing, because sometimes it tries to do that. And then you'll have a hole or no fun. So make sure your bodice is out of the way as you're sewing this on. My sleeves are on. Make sure that you look and make sure they're cut everywhere. You don't want them to have a spot. That is not right. And my sleeves are on. Look at this cute little number. I want it. I just want this little top for myself. And it is so soft. This fabric is amazing. Neck band. This is where we're going next. Okay, so I've got my neck band. I'm going to open it up. I'm going to fold it wrong sides together to give it that memory crease. And then we're going to fold it right sides together at the short raw edge. Sew that together. Okay, I'm leaving thread everywhere. I know, my room, okay, so a couple weeks ago, my grandmother came and I didn't ask her to. She's just amazing. I love her so much. And she cleaned out my sewing room while I went to work. I came back. My sewing room looks brand spanking new. My fabrics, she folded all my fabrics. They look amazing. I feel like I need more fabric because when she folded it, she did such a good job. Like everything fit nicer. So it's taking up less space and I feel like there's a couple empty spots. I guess I could put some of my fabric that's over here on my spot, but I don't know. I feel like I just need to get new fabric. You know what I mean, Jelly Bean? Anyway, and she cleaned everything. She vacuumed and I mean, like
behind my machines, clean my, I'm like, wow. And so I wasn't even gone for that long. Like, I don't even know. I'm sure she did some kind of weird magic. I don't know how she got it all done. So anyway, now she's been gone for a couple of weeks and I've been doing insane sewing, last minute sewing, because that's what I'm good at. And so there is little pieces of thread everywhere, fabric pieces all over, pattern pieces all over. And I feel like if my grandma came in here now, she'd be like, oh, love, let me clean your room. Like, honestly, that's the kind of person she is. She's amazing. She would never be like, oh, why did you do that? She'd just be like, oh, let me clean it for you. I know you've been working so much. And she's just so sweet. Honestly, I'm like about in tears because I love her so much. But anyway, don't know where I was going with that. There's thread everywhere. There's pieces of fuss everywhere. Is that how your sewing room is? Please tell me I'm not the only one. All right, I'm folding it wrong sides together again, meeting those raw edges. But honestly, my room is not a total mess. It's just very creative. You know, I'm making creative things in here. My, you know, creative juices are flowing. Do you sometimes, I'm just finding my half. I just folded it in half. Now I'm gonna match the front and the back and find a quarter. So that's what I'm doing while I'm just yapping away. I don't know if you do this, but sometimes I will be working on something, a pattern or whatever it is that I'm working on. And all of a sudden a notification came up. My sister is messaging me. Sorry about that. I see some fabric or something and I all of a sudden think, oh my word, this would make an amazing whatever. And I could be in the middle of doing a project and I stop dead on my tracks. The project gets left behind. And I go in and dive headfirst into whatever my mind just came up with. You know, like, I'm going to match these two patterns. Okay, let's go. You know, like, just be thankful that I don't, that something doesn't come into my mind while I'm sitting here talking to you all. Because I might leave you and just go work on that project. It is so funny. I don't know why I'm that way. Are you that way? And so then I end up having multiple projects that are on my sewing table that haven't, some have started, some haven't, some are halfway done. I have a fairy jacket halfway done over there. I thought about not lining it. And then you could see too much of the fabric when it would fold over and it was the wrong side of the fabric. I didn't like it. So I'm gonna line it, but I don't have enough fabric. So now I'm thinking I'm just gonna line half of it. So that way the part that folds over is lined, but the back won't be lined and everything else won't be lined because I don't have enough fabric. So I'm working on that. So that's sitting there. And I'm working on a bunch of other things. Just anyway, you don't care. Let me move on. Let's finish this top because you want to see our top finished. All right, shoulder seams together. We're going to the front. And here is my front. And here's my back. And now, your shoulders are not your seams, your sides. You have to make sure you match the front and the back and you go to one side and that's where your quarter is. And then you go to the other side and that's where your other quarter is. Now, with this tiny size, it's not too far away from the seam. It really literally is like a half an inch away from the seam. Half an inch and half an inch make a difference. It's a whole inch leeway that you will have a whole inch more fabric to have in the back and less in the front. It'll be like really tight in the front. But the bigger sizes, it's a lot more of room. And then if you don't measure it correctly, your neckband will not sit right. So you gotta make sure that you measure correctly. And then now I'm gonna match those quarter points with my neckband, right sides together, raw edges at the top. And I'm just matching those quarter points. I'm so sorry about that. When I'm excited, I tend to sing. Could that be really called singing? All right, we're gonna go ahead and sew that neckband on. Okay, you're gonna lightly stretch the neckband to fit You want to make sure that when I sew my neck band is always face up. There is really an actual explanation for that. I saw it the other day. I can't remember it. But there is, you are technically, it's up to you, whatever you want to do. But technically, I guess you're supposed to sew the neck band up. And I never knew that. I just do it because it helps me. Neck band up, fingers holding that neck band, stretch it out a little bit. Make sure it's even and we go. I always stop at every quarter point because I want to make sure that I go to the next part and I fix my fabric really nicely, the raw edges together, and go. And next quarter point, raw edges together and go. Make sure your top is not coming in at the bottom and it's gonna get caught underneath there. That will not be fun. All right, I wanna make sure that my neck band all got caught in there. How cute. We're gonna turn it around and I'm going to steam my neck band down. Just cause I wanna make sure that my neck band is nice and steamed, and I like to do it inside out cause then I can see my neck band going the right way. All of it is going the right way. The seam, it's all going in towards the bodice. If you're having ripples on your neck band, you wanna make sure it's all going, the seam is all going the right way. If part of it is going up and part of it is going down, that's gonna make it ripple as well. This little surging tail, what I usually do with it, I grab the tail, I put it right on top of the seam, right on top of the seam, the front or the back, usually I do it in the back, and then I do a zigzag stitch over it and get it caught in there. That's how I get rid of it. How cute. Waistband. Here's my waistband. We are doing basically the same thing we did for the armband. I'm gonna fold the waistband first. Right sides, wrong sides together. I'm sorry to create that crease. Okay, now we're gonna open it. Fold it right sides together. At the short raw edge, we're gonna fold it, sew it. Make it one continuous band. One continuous band. And then we're gonna fold it again. We're gonna pin. Oh my word. And we're gonna go to one side, half. We're quartering. Because I want to, my front, my back, my sides. I already have side seams on my top, so I don't really have to find my sides. I just will find my front and my back. Because the sides and some of the side seams on my top will be my side seams. So I'm gonna grab my front and my back. I go to the back. Here's my back point. Side seams, I go to the front. The front is where your pocket should be. You should have your pocket right there. So when you go to sew this on, I've done this before. So listen to me. Be careful that you don't grab your pocket or your front bodice and match it up with your back, thinking that's your pocket and thinking this is your front. Then it will be like this and you won't be able to put their head in there because it won't be right. So make sure the front is with the front and the back is with the front back. If it helps, you might want to pin it or whatever. What we're gonna do now is, as you can see, our band is smaller, way smaller than our top. Again, that is a blousing effect, that is why. So we're gonna grab it, and we're going to do what? We're going to gather it. So we're going to do that long basting stitch. Told you you could kind of grab it here, and that will help you gather. That you don't have to. We're just doing that long basting stitch. That's how I'm going to gather. You can use whatever preferred method of gathering is. That will be just fine. This is my preferred method when I'm doing something like this. I feel like it's really not that much gathering. Some little girl dresses have a lot of gathering. This is not very much. So it's a little bit gathered, but obviously I need to gather a little bit more. So I'm gonna grab at it and gather it a little bit, the width of my band. Where's the other side?
I want to gather from the both sides because I want to make sure that it's even Stevens. Okay.
Now see, it's gathered the width of my band.
Very cute. I want to make sure that my gathers are even. So I am evening them out. Divvying them out. I don't want one side to be more gathered than the other one.
Perfecto. Okay, so this is my front bodice. So I want the front where there's no seam. I'm gonna match that up right here where my front bodice is. Remember, your pocket should be right there. Right sides together and your pocket should be in the front seam. Then we're going to that side seam, match that up. And then we're going to the back where we found that half, that mark, match that up. And then the other side seam, match that up. And we are almost done. This is our last set for our top. And then our leg warmers are like a lickety split. Like they're super quick, super quick. I'm just matching these raw edges, matching the raw edges together, pinning. So that I can sew. And then I'm gonna go ahead and sew on my sewing machine, my serger, I'm sorry. Okay, let me tell you this. If you are a little bit hesitant sometimes with your gathers, you can go ahead and do a basting stitch or a zigzag stitch on your sewing machine, a big zigzag stitch, and get it on there and try it on and see if your gathers look like they're nice and even. And if they don't, then just go back and fix them and then serge them on. I've done that before when it's something that's a lot of gathering and I'm scared, like, well, I don't know if I gathered this correctly. I'm gonna just baste it on with a zigzag stitch, a big zigzag, not this big, but you know, a pretty good size zigzag stitch that will be easy to pull off afterwards when I'm fixing it. So I'm gonna go ahead and sew this on and we'll be done with our top. You can do gathers up top so you can see them as they're coming into the serger. And then we'll be done with our top and we'll move on to our leg warmers. Move right. Make sure that all of it is caught in. I always want to look at it again very carefully because, you know, sometimes you can, with pleats especially, get it not all the way in, a pleat not all the way in, and then you're like wearing it later on and you find a hole, so you want to make sure that it's all good. Okay, so I'm going to be, sorry, that if you heard that, that was my basting stitch. That was not my top, thankfully. Yeah, I'm just trying to pull that basting stitch, but I'll finish getting it later. All right, my top is done. Look at how cute this is. All right. Steaming. Make sure, see how wobbly it is? Wobbly. You want it all to go the right way, the same way. If you're pushing it all up, you're pushing it all up. If you're pushing it all down, you're pushing it all down. Do it the right way, because that way, steam it, that way it gives it a better look. All right, I have to go back and do it again later because I have to pull that basting stitch. I was just showing you. I want to eat it.
How cute is this thing? Anyway, leg warmer time. Got my leg warmer. I'm telling you, this is so easy. 2 seconds. Match it up.
raw right sides together, raw edges meeting. We're gonna pin, we're going to sew it together on that straight line. If you have a child that does not love seams, you may want to do a after you're done doing this, if you open it up like this and then you steam it down, you can use like ribbon, like silky stuff, if they would rather have that, and then I would put it right on top and then top stitch it on over that seam. And then if you top stitch it with thread of the same color of the leg warmer, you won't be able to see it, and you'll have a silky basted over that seam, because I know that can be kind of annoying for some children and some adults as well. So that was just a, you know, if you have some child that is, my son doesn't really love the seams, but he's not, it's not horrible. He's fine with it. But I just know that some kids really have a hard time with it. And, you know, we don't want to, that's just an extra option if you want to do that. Anyway, this is my cuff. We're folding it wrong sides together, steaming. Then I'm going to fold it right sides together. So the short edge. We're just doing the same thing that we did on the arms and everything, but this time I don't think we have to gather. It's up to you if you want to gather. I think you could do it without gathering. I'm gonna fold it right sides together. Come on. And then we're gonna meet up the back, close it together, find my half. I'm gonna find my half on my tight, my warmer, and then I'm going to put it on and pin it. Right sides together, right edges at the top, and we're only doing this for one side, and then the other side will just be hemmed. That will be the bottom. And here's my front. If you wanted to gather it, you can gather it. If you wanted to quarter it, you can quarter it. I only halved it because that's what I am. Then you're gonna stretch it out and sew it on. Okay, go to the half or quarter point, whatever you made, and sew. And then the last part. Then we are basically done. Just make sure it's all sewn on right. Turn it. You can go ahead and turn it inside out like I usually do and steam those seams. Look at this. This is like a glove, you know, like, oh, I'm gonna make myself some gloves with this. Turn it. This is a 12-month size, by the way, if you wanted to make yourself some gloves, because you just saw me doing that and you're like, oh, what size was that? 12 months for these arms. I am a size small, so in case you were wondering. I don't know why I just told you that. Anyway, then at the top, at the other end, we fold it half an inch down, steam, and hem. And our leg warmers are ready. How cute is this little outfit? I'm going to eat it, and then I'll see you all next time. Just kidding. Anyway, I won't eat it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you had a lot of fun. Please let me know below if you have any questions about anything that I did whatsoever. Please, if you're not part of our Instagram or Facebook community, come join us. We have lots of fun. We have lots of giveaway. We have lots of sewing tutorials. We have giveaways. We have fun. And we'd love to see what you're making. Come show us what you're making. Come see what everybody else is in the community is making. And also, if you haven't subscribed, subscribe so you don't miss out any other tutorials. Subscribe, comment, like, share with your friends so they can we can all sew together. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!